There is an in-service going on, and it's all about new updates about wound care management. It is mandatory that all staff should attend the said in-service, but Mario was not present again.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thanks for coming to our in-service. Our topic for today is about wound care management, and we're going to discuss the wound care dressing management. It's the vacuum-assisted closure dressing. So I have a picture here, and I'm going to distribute the handouts for you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Did you see Mario?
Well, as usual, he's not here again. What would you expect?
Oops, and for sure, he won't stop asking questions again.
Yeah, he's so incompetent. Oh my God, yeah. I wonder why he's here.
Okay, so that's all for today. Do you have any question?
No.
Okay.
No.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
See you again next week.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
The next morning at the nurse's station, Mario approached Joanne and asked about the in-service that was conducted yesterday.
Hi, Joanne.
Hi, Mario.
How are you?
I'm good.
You're good?
Yeah.
How was the in-service yesterday?
Oh, it was good. It was good. Yeah.
It was good?
Yeah.
What did you talk about?
Oh, you know what, Mario, I'm so sorry, but I have to go to my client because they're waiting for me. So we could just ask maybe Shanti or me. Yeah, I
know.
Yeah.
What happened?
I know, I understand, but I'm so sorry. I can't help you right now. So, okay,
right.
Bye-bye.
Okay.
See ya.
Hi, Lini.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Good.
Good. Did you attend the insurance lesson?
So you can ask for somebody else.
Mario went to his client, shaking his head. His assigned client is Mrs. Chu, with a pressure ulcer of grade 4. He'd been assigned to this client for 5 days now, and he usually applied dressing pack. But the wound is not getting any better. It was discussed in the in-service and was ordered to start today. Mario missed that, and the patient will be using the wound vacuum therapy and change dressing every 48 hours and PRN.
Hello, Miss Chu. Hi, how are you?
Hi.
No, I'm Joel. I'm your nurse tonight.
Nice to meet you.
How are you doing?
Okay.
I'm here to do the change of dressing, you know?
Okay.
Right, so I'm gonna prepare the... How's your wound so far?
I'm having pain on my
wound. Let me check. Can you turn your side, please?
Yeah.
You know what? I'm gonna change it to dressing, okay?
Okay.
Okay. All right. So just kindly still do the on your side, and I'll do prepare the dressing, okay?
Mario prepares the equipment and about to apply the dressing pack.
Oh, what is that? Dr. Smith, in this morning, Dr. Smith told me that you're going to use some machine, not this dressing.
With the machine?
Yes.
Mrs. Chu, I'm not sure about that order. Let me double check, okay?
Okay.
Hold on.
Mario approached Joanne and he verified Mrs.
Hi, Joanne.
Yeah.
Sorry to bother you. Can you use the computer, please?
Oh, is there any problem?
Yeah, with regards to Mrs. Chu's dressing order, you know, about with the machine? I don't know with the machine.
Yeah, it was discussed to the in-service yesterday that we're going to use vacuum-assisted closure dressing, and because wound is not helping her. Come on.
Joanne runs to the patient's room and checks the said dressing. Mario stands beside her.
You know, Joanne, I tried to wash this machine, right?
But Mario, I was busy this morning. I have lots of patients to attend to. Really? Can you turn to the other side, please? I'm sorry. Yeah, it was discussed yesterday to the in-service that we're not going to use the dressing anymore. We're going to use a vacuum-assisted dressing because her wound is not that package is not helping her. And look, her wound is still the same. So, you know what, Mario? I'm so sorry I can't help you. If you just attended yesterday, then there will be no problem like that.
Joanne left Mario.
Mrs. Chu, hi. Again, to be honest, I don't know how to do the dressing. So I'll do the same wound care that I do the other day. And you'll be okay, fine? No, you would say,
On the station, Joanne is endorsing to nurse two for break, and Shanti is also with them.
You know what? Mario did one packing instead of one vacuum therapy to Mrs. Chu. He's so incompetent, you know, and he is always absent. He's not here, and then he's, oh my God, he's terrible.
Yeah, he approached me, but I haven't had a chance to discuss this because I am very busy with my patient.
Yeah, he's not good at all anyway. He's so slow and he asks questions. I don't know what are we going to do to him.
Yeah, can we report this to the management?
Well, I think it's better. You have to do that.
The next morning after shift.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Hi, I want to report to you about my colleague. His name is Mario, and first of all, he's always absent at the in-service and he doesn't know what he's doing. So he's very incompetent and I don't know, we have a problem about him.
How can you say that?
Well, yesterday he did something with Mrs. Chu. He, instead of using the assisted wound vacuum, he did the wound dressing instead. So he wasn't here, he doesn't know what he was doing.
Oh, let me see what can I do, and I will see Mario and talk to him.
Okay, thank you very much.
No problem.
Mario is still in the unit and was called to go to the nurse manager's office. And so Mario went to the manager's office.
Come in.
Hi.
Hi, Mario. Please have a seat.
Okay. You call me?
Yes, I call you. I received a complaint that you are not doing your job well.
Is it the in-service you're talking about? I have a lot of concerns about every time I have to think of the family and kids. And because I'm working night, so I cannot go and attend the in-service. Mm-hmm.
Exactly, and because of that, your co-staff told me that you did wound packing instead of the wound vacuum.
Yes, so what is that? That was the dressing that I did from the other day. And you know what? I asked Joanne and Lini about how would be the dressing for the patient, but they ignored me. I don't know about the kind of dressing that we'll do, even with the doctor's order, but they really they didn't help me at all.
Okay, I will go over your schedule so this won't happen again. And make sure to do you better and show that you deserve this job. Okay, and I will talk to John and other staff.
Mario received his schedule for the week with 3 nights, 2 days off, and 2 nights again. Monday, Tuesday night shift, Wednesday, Thursday off, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday night shift, and a notification of an incoming in-service.
What am I going to do now? You know, Shanti, I thought she was going to fix my schedule. How can I attend the in-service again? I might exchange my shift to someone. Do you mind if I ask you for your working Tuesday?
Oh, yes. I'm doing the afternoon work.
Really? Is it possible that we can have a switch? If you say yes, I'll approach the manager and arrange for the schedule.
I'm sorry, Mario. I have a party to attend after my work.
I have to attend in service really for, you know, I never attended this discussion for a long time. But if you can't say yes, it's okay. Thanks anyway.
Joanne and Shanti are having discussion.
You know, Joanne, Mario approached me a while ago.
Mm-hmm.
He asked me to switch the shift for in service. But you know, I turned him down. I need to attend a party.
Oh my gosh, don't tell me that he's not going to attend the in-service again. Oh my gosh, you know what? He's very incompetent, irresponsible. You know, I asked him to check on the patient, the room 203, and you know what? He didn't do anything. So I don't know, what are we going to do with him?
Mario heard the conversation and felt bad. He felt so belittled and humiliated, so he decided to write a resignation letter and hand it to the nurse manager.
Come on.
Hi again.
Hello, how are you?
I'm actually not fine.
What are your concerns? We can talk about it.
I feel like it seems like we're not working here as a team. I'm always criticized and I'm always ignored by my colleagues. Every time I feel like they're not helping me. And it didn't happen once, but many times. So I think I have to just quit the job.
I need you both to discuss this matter to let me get positive results. And we must work as a good team. And here with the same purpose and goals. Yeah. So let me call John. Okay.
Hi.
Hi, John. How are you?
Good.
After the meeting with Joanne, Shanti, and other staff, they agreed and apologized to one another. They also agreed that they will share responsibilities and be able to do shift duties. And in the end, they ended up into a good team. So in the above scenario, we can see that there is no passive collegial relationship between Mario, Joanne, and other staff. Until such time, the conflict has been resolved. According to the College of Nurses of Ontario, good communication, mutual acceptance, and understanding effectively will help to foster a work environment that produces positive outcome for both nurses, co-staff, yeah, and clients.
Because since